guys, we get it in La Fillette. Captain Andrew.
Myself, I'm a Bradley and Terry. Trying to tip at the same time, but you know,
it might be a little unsuccessful.
Yeah, it's right. This is how the sea looking this morning.
Again, I'll fight by Kevin, boys.
Guys, we're back from a long day, well, early a long day of fishing, a couple of hours of fishing. And the captain here driving, I just taking a really relaxed first thing, that's epic.
Operation here.
First we held some fish, also held some maya, we held a maya as well.
These are the basic utensils that we'll be using to clean these fish today. So we have a salmon, two salmon, a redfish, and a maya.
Alright, so basically we're gonna clean these fish today. The salmon, we're gonna slice them. The redfish, we're gonna bake. Cleanest one for baking. And the mahi mahi, we're gonna do this fillet. So you're gonna see another short clip of the fillet as well today. This knife, which is a nice long knife, a pretty heavy knife too, so you can use this for slicing on the fish, okay? So I'm gonna slice it in slanted slices. But then one has locally known as Ornaman's Lettuce. Right. So here we have your tail, nice slice of fish, fresh fish. Slices from the fish itself. Now this here, being the guts on the inside, you will take it out. Make sure it's properly well clean. Most people take off the bloodline, so you can do this here and take off the bloodline from the fish. So nice and simple, it comes off. Same procedure. When you're seasoning and washing and seasoning your fish, you also see, you always take off the remnants of the blood on the fish itself. So now we're going to cut down the head in half. With a little bit of fringiness, and make sure it is totally nice and presentable. Alright, so what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna cut here all the way up to the head. Head is normally the hardest part of the fish. Cut it on the center. What I'm gonna do now is open, take off the gills,
take off the gills, the remnants of the guts here. I'm gonna take it off. Right? And now when you're washing your fish with your lime or whatever you wash it with, whether it be vinegar or salt, or any vinegar to the red fish, right? Same procedure basically. Cut off all the fins, use your scissors. This here normally has a really, really, really tough bone. Right? But a strong enough scissor will be able to cut it for you. Right? Perfect. That's off. We do a proper job here. Cut off the fins. Because this fish is going to be used for baking. Right? It's a pretty decent sized redfish. It fits in most Pyrex dishes. Cut off the tail. And the top fin as well. Alright, so we on to our scaling process. Back to my fork again here. Now when cleaning fish, is always important to have running water. Running water makes your job easier, it isn't that messy. Alright, see how nice and quickly these scales come out. Some of these scales can be really, really stubborn, but with the fork it does a pretty thorough job. Remember all the underbelly. So this is the next side of the fish. Alright, make sure all these scales are out. On the head here, importantly, there are some scales that you'll want to take off. Because you don't want to be eating the fish and realize that there are scales on the head of the fish. Alright, so importantly again, running water. To make sure that the scales are washed off on the board you're using. Right, so normally, as I was saying, there are some stubborn scales on the fish itself. Right, so you want to get rid of these scales, pass back the fork after the fish is thoroughly washed, and make sure that there are no scales remaining on the fish. Notice how I use the fork here? On the curve, because it's kind of difficult, you'll see them going in the groove like this. Going to the back, so what I'm gonna do now, I'm gonna take all the guts from the fish, because I'm gonna use this fish for baking. So I'm gonna cut from the back here, straight up to the front, and then I'm gonna reach inside and I'm gonna take out all the guts from inside the fish, including there's a bag here. If you don't get all, now it's okay. When you're washing the fish, it's important to get that bag out of there. I will rip here. If not, you can cut it here. Take all the gills and some of the guts will come out here. So I'm trying to get all of the underbelly here. Not really underbelly, it's like a film of skin that really needs to come out. Alright, so you can try with the fork. And see if it comes simpler here. Nice. Fork is actually doing a pretty good job. Nice. So when you're washing the fish, you can take off the rest of the underbelly, right? What I would normally do here, on the fish itself, I would make little incision slices just to use the spine.
And
this way now, if you, when you're baking, you can put your lemon slices in the incisions and your seasonings will go properly inside here to make sure the fish soaks up all the flavors of the seasoning.
Alright, so we went to the Mai Mai. I also caught this Mai Mai on Sunday, but I didn't have any video footage of me actually reeling in with my rod. So it's a simple fillet video again. So basically, it was said in my last video how to fillet. So this is a Mai Mai basically, and you have a lot of meat in your head, so you don't want to lose all that meat. You're basically feeling for the line of the fish, and here's the line of the fish. Make an incision here to the meat, come around, come around. Right, feeling for the underbelly of the Mai Mai. Alright, nice. So we have here, right around. Right, any fish now. So we're feeling now for the back of the fish. So we can start from the top or the back. Right now, I'm going to start from the center. So here it is. From your feel. The spine all the way up to the top. Here we have the Mai Mai. Come in. Right. So you're hearing the knife rubbing against the bone of the fish while going down. Front. We come up now. The knife. One side of the fillet Mai Mai. Alright. The fish still on the, there's still a lot of fish, but this meat is really thick, so you can actually use this. Use your knife. Take up all that excess meat. There you have chunks to do some fries.
Much up there.
You can still use this carcass. You can make a steam fish with this carcass because it's actually really, really good if you steam it with some okras and seasonings, tomatoes and coconut mint. You'll have a really, really nice steam fish and provision. So don't forget to like, subscribe. Look for more of my videos, and I really appreciate your views and shares, guys. Have a good day.
head now.